welcome to the ABL live stream for tonight's game between the number 4 Saigon Heat and the number 2 high-tech Bangkok City. I'm your commentator, Darren Joe, and it's my pleasure to call this game out for you live from Saigon, Vietnam. It's all smiles today for both teams, and it's been a dramatic past 2 weeks. The Saigon Heat, with their backs against the wall, have won 2 consecutive games against the Jobstreet.com Singapore Slingers, and just 3 days ago against the Indonesia Warriors in dramatic fashion, 75-73, to make the ABL playoffs for the first time in team history. The Heat were without star international import Dustin Scott and had to make a last-minute substitution and brought in Mark Yee from the Philippines. And even with only one international import, they were still able to squeak out a win over fifth-place Indonesia Warriors. So the team was relieved, overjoyed, and they're dedicating this season and the playoffs to coach Jason Rabideau. Now, for high-tech Bangkok City, they're coming off a tough overtime loss to the Malaysia Dragons. High-tech Bangkok City was the number 1 team in the ABL before that loss and have slipped to number 2. And if Westport Malaysia Dragons beat Laskar Drea South Sumatra today, they will finish this fifth season of the ABL in the number 1 position. But it's still been a great season for high-tech Bangkok City with a 13-5 record, powered by their twin towers, Chris Charles and Stephen Thomas, and strong local play from players like Woody Pong Dawson and Watana Sudison and Jarek Kenyatta. They're a team to be reckoned with in the ABL playoffs coming up soon. So this game, last game of the season for the Saigon Heat, and the second to last game of the season for High Tech. It won't determine the outcome. If Malaysia Dragons win tonight, as I mentioned, they'll be number 1 seed in the playoffs and play the Saigon Heat, who are the 4th seed. However, if Malaysia Dragons lose, and High Tech wins this game and their next game against the Slingers, then High Tech would be the number 1 team. But it's likely that the Dragons will beat Laskar Drea. Now we're going to see, as we see the starting lineup for High Tech Bangkok City, Chris Charles, what a presence he's been for this team at center. Stephen Thomas at the power forward. Jarek Kenyatta and Muntipong Dawson in the backcourt. And Montien at the forward spot. Justin Williams, what a game he had against the Indonesia Warriors. Justin Williams had 30 rebounds in the last game against the Warriors. And he's put in the final touches on an MVP season, for sure. In this game, because it will not affect the Saigon Heat's playoff rankings, Coach Tony Carbaletto has mentioned that he'd like to give his local players more burn this game. And as we can see, new import player Dmitry Guchko from Ukraine will be stepping in to replace Dustin Scott, who unfortunately, because of a passport problem, will no longer be with the Saigon Heat this season. Coach Carbaletto, as we see Dustin Scott, who is a crowd favorite here at CIS Arena, will no longer play with this team, but of course will be their biggest fan. So So, starting this game for the Saigon Heat, the first different starting lineup we've seen the entire season. Justin Williams at center, Dmitry Guchko at power forward, Fanshan Mun, the local player, will be starting at small forward, and Ryan Lay and Viet Arnold will start in the backcourt. The commissioner of the game is Tong Kia Ka, and our referees are Liang Chun Wing, Harahap Irwin, and Chu Wei Chuen. Now, we're going to take a moment of pause for each team's national anthem. The two teams meeting at center court and the Saigon Heat crowd. It's another sold-out game at CIS Arena this season. Even in this very last game that will have no effect on the Heat's playoff chances, it's still a packed stadium, and Heat fans love their team and love that man, Justin Williams, for the effort he has given in these last couple games. Incredible effort on the glass and on defense for Justin Williams. What are the keys to today's game for both teams? Well, for the home team, Saigon Heat, they have lost the previous three games to high-tech Bangkok City. So Saigon Heat have yet to get a win over Bangkok. And in all those games, except one, the high-tech Bangkok City have out-rebounded the Saigon Heat and have gotten many more points in the paint with their twin towers, Thomas and Charles, against the Saigon Heat. So for the Saigon Heat, they're gonna wanna limit those points in the paint and force high-tech Bangkok City's perimeter players to knock down some jump shots. On the opposite end of the floor, on defense, they're gonna need to really box out. Without Dustin Scott, with new import Dmitry Guchko, it's gonna have to keep the big guys and big front court of high-tech Bangkok City off the boards. Also, local players from Saigon Heat will get a lot more time in this game and to show off their stuff and get some confidence before the playoffs. For high-tech Bangkok City, what are the keys for them? Well, move the ball, make shots. High-tech Bangkok City have a very high assist to field goal ratio, one of the highest in the league. In fact, in the last two games against the Saigon Heat, they had 17 assists to 29 field goals and 21 assists to 31 field goals. So they like to pass the ball and set each other up. And of course, they have the bruising front court of Chris Charles and Stephen Thomas. Another key for high-tech Bangkok City is simply to not get hurt, you know? Stay in the game, get your rhythm, you know, get some competition in, but they want to make sure they have all their starters for the playoffs, which will be starting this Wednesday. This Wednesday evening, you can catch all those games on the ABL live stream. Just go to ASEANBasketballLeague.com, and those two games will be around 7 o'clock, and it's going to be an exciting playoffs with all teams going full throttle. So don't miss any of those games, with the first playoff games coming up on October 29th. That's this Wednesday evening. You can also follow the games at youtube.com/ABL. So Stephen Thomas, one-time AirAsia ABL Defensive Player of the Year, still a beast down low. And what leadership he has shown to high-tech Bangkok City. So Phan Tran Mun will get his first start of the season, and he'll be matched up against local player Mon Tien. Mon Tien Wong Sawank them, and tip-off goes to Wudipong Donovan Dawson. So see, he's going to 2-3 defense. Charles misses the first shot. Arnold covers the rebound, gets it ahead to Mun. It's falling out of bounds, has to throw the ball away. Here comes Kenyatta, one of the speediest players in the league. He goes all the way. Nothing there, so sloppy start for both teams. Viet Arnold wearing a headband today. Interesting look. Nan gets it in to Justin Williams. Takes an outside shot against Stephen Thomas. Air ball. Charles goes way too hard off the glass. And it's almost like an all-star game to start this game. Williams all the way. He misses a layup. So a comedy of errors to start this first period. So Ryan Lay and Phan Tran Mun, both local players, getting their first start of the season. Charles misses another layup point blank. It's a really rare thing to see for Chris Charles, who's absolutely deadly down low. Ryan Lay works the pick and roll with Guchko. Guchko thinks about it. Fall away, rejected from Charles. His first block of the game. Williams comes up short. Guchko gets blocked again. So add two blocks to Chris Charles, who is fighting for that top blocks leader in the ABL this year. In fact, Chris Charles averaging 4 blocks a game is second in the league, whereas Justin Williams has 4.5 blocks. He's first in the league. So if you're talking about the All Air Asia ABL SWAT team, you got your two leaders here, Charles and Williams. I wouldn't want to be taking it to the hole against these guys, that's for sure. Charles breaks the ice, makes both his free throws. And Charles has shot a pretty solid 66% from the stripe. So for a big guy, that's pretty solid percentage from the free throw line. Guchko, he has the range. There it is. Let's talk about Dmitry Guchko. Guchko is from the Ukraine, and what a story he has. He actually left the Ukraine as, you know, Ukraine and Russia were going through conflict. Came to Vietnam to start life anew, and is a practice player for the Saigon Heat. As he dishes the ball to Mun, Mun's gonna take it all the way, too hard off the glass. Williams, follow-up throwdown. Williams has been doing that all season, as he gives the Heat a 5-2 lead, but Guchko, again from the Ukraine, practice player for the Saigon Heat. As you see, he's got the crazy buzz cut, and an interesting story about Dmitry. He's actually a hairstylist. So when he's not trying to box out Stephen Thomas, he's cutting hair. The Saigon Heat Justin Williams is having too much fun out there. Shooting a three-pointer in the first 10 seconds of the possession. Guchko draws the offensive foul from Charles. So Dmitry Guchko showing his presence and perhaps clamoring for a spot on the Saigon Heat as they move into the playoffs. So some of you may be asking, well, where's Dustin Scott? Dustin Scott, one of the star players for the Heat this year, the butler, one of my favorite players on the team, did not make the trip out to play the Indonesia Warriors in that clutch game on Wednesday. Finishes with the finger roll. Because Dustin Scott had passport issues. So he was not able to make the trip to Indonesia. And the Saigon Warriors, hurrying to find another big man, had to release Dustin Scott off the roster. So Dustin Scott will no longer play for the Saigon Heat this season. So Mark Yee from the Philippines filled in admirably in their last game against the Warriors. Got about 10 points and 9 rebounds for them. But he couldn't make this game because of his passport problems. So the Saigon Heat have chosen to go with Guchko from Ukraine to play this game. As we see a beautiful pass to Dawson, who finishes cleanly on the other end. So who will play as an international import for the Saigon Heat? Will be Guchko or another player who the Heat are surely looking for right now. Arnold misses the three. Kenyatta gets it to Montien, too strong. Dawson, offensive rebound. Nice, strong take from Wudipong Dawson. You know, one of the strongest and most explosive leapers. Dawson was in last year's slam dunk competition. And he's had a solid year for high tech, making his case to perhaps be an MVP or local player MVP in the league. I'd have to say it's probably between him and Long Way Long, as Guchko hits his second shot. He started the game on fire. What a start for Dmitry Guchko. He puts the Saigon Heat up 10-6, 4:50 left. We'll be right back. So we see Coach Jing Ruiz of High Tech Bangkok City trying to make adjustments to Dmitry Guchko, who he's never seen play before, and he's quickly realizing that Guchko has some range for a big man. The big man from Ukraine, already with 6 points and 3 rebounds in the first 5 minutes. What a start for Dmitry Guchko, his first ever game in the ABL. Justin Williams shooting 1-for-6 from the field goal line. Trying that wild three, and Justin Williams is having some fun out there. But Bangkok City, top team in this league, they're still gonna want to win this game. If anything, to send a message to the Saigon Heat that they're still the best team in this league. Heat in a 2-3 zone. Dawson, this is badly on the three. It'll be Heat ball. So starting point guard, Froy Baggy on the magician, has checked back in. And Heat need to get the ball, barely beat the penalty. Lay, got some ugly possessions there, and Dawson will finish and one. So no one from the Saigon Heat is paying attention there, and left their point guard, Froy Baggy, stranded in the backcourt. A Ryan Lay and Viet Arnold need to be more aware of their point guard there. The turnover on the Saigon Heat. Dawson with a strong start to this game. I'll give him 5 points. Heat set up their offense. What a matchup. Bagion and Kenyatta. You have the magician against the speed demon. Williams, the tough fall away jumper. It's not really his move. And Montien will go over Williams. What a finish from Montien, high off the glass. Incredible stuff from Montien. Williams, another shot. No. So Williams starting off ice cold from the field, 1 for 8. Thomas, he can make that. Misses it that time. Arnold and Williams. Wow, what defense from Stephen Thomas. Strips Viet Arnold. And Montien with another finish. Montien has a set of wheels. Goodness gracious. He's fast. So he and Jared Kenyatta, definitely probably the speediest backcourt in the ABL. We're going to have an offensive foul on Guchko. So Heat have gone cold. And Avenido will check in for Arnold. So Avenido and Bagyan were both exhausted after that incredible 75-73 overtime win against the Warriors. Coach Carboletto mentioning he'll probably play Avenido and Bagyan about 20 minutes this game, give his local players like Ryan Lay and Fen Tran Munn a chance to shine. Charles, nice pass to Dawson. That's a goaltend on Guchko. So after a strong start by the Saigon Heat, High Tech up 15-10. A key metric for the Heat is their assist to field goal ratio. If they can keep that high and play less one-on-one basketball, they're really tough to beat. Lay, trying to prevent a backcourt penalty, throws the ball away. And I'm sure Coach Carboletto wants to see a little more focus from his players. Fen Tran Munn comes in for Lay. So Heat continue with a 2-3 defensive zone. And interestingly enough against High Tech, the Heat haven't been able to score more than 17 points a quarter against High Tech in three games against High Tech. So Coach Ruiz has really figured out a way to keep the lid on the Saigon Heat. Pump fake finish from Williams. That's hang time, folks. Williams, an explosive leaper, gets his second field goal. Montien's feeling it. Why not a three? Nails it. So what a start for Wudipong Dawson and Montien. Montien now with 7 points. And he's showing Coach Ruiz that he can be a solid contributor come playoff time for High Tech. Playing some tenacious D on Bagyan as well. Munn gets sent packing by Thomas. Recovered by Avenido. 3 seconds left. Bagyan forced to shoot it. Air ball. So another great defensive set from High Tech. Oh, nice look. Kenyatta to Charles. Great stuff. Kenyatta froze the defense, was looking at Dawson, faked out the defenders and found his big man. And Bangkok City rolling. Maybe they want that one seed. Maybe they want that home court advantage in case the Dragons lose tonight. Williams takes it up strong and is hacked by Thomas. So Chen Tianten will come in, but now on the floor. Heat down by 9. Traditionally, the Heat start off well in the first quarter. This quarter has been different. And they find themselves down by 9 points, We'll be right back. Games to play when you know not much is hanging in the balance for both teams, guaranteed playoff spots, and both wanting to avoid injury. So it's tough to find that right level of concentration in games like this at the end of the season. But what can you say about Justin Williams' effort in the last game against the Indonesia Warriors that clinched the Saigon Heat's first ever playoff appearance in three seasons in the ABL? There is Williams misses the first free throw. There was a great picture after that game. I'm sure some of you caught it on the live stream, but there was a great picture of Justin Williams hugging coach Tony Carbaletto. So much joy and relief after winning that game. Such an emotional game, and the Heat are dedicating that game and the rest of the season to coach Jason Rabideau, who passed away a month ago. And this season is for their coach, their beloved coach. So I'm sure he's looking down and is smiling that his Saigon Heat are in the playoffs for the first time in team history. Magian. Munn's open for three, high arc and shot, too strong. Williams, second chance, good. Kenyatta wisely slows it down. Oh, what a pass, Kenyatta to Charles. And that's the second alley-oop play. So we see Williams with the follow-up. But what an alley-oop between Kenyatta and Charles. These two guys have ESP. They don't even have to see each other. They know where they are, where each other are at all times. Kabah hug to beat the buzzer. No. So High Tech, after a slow start, comes out rolling. They're shooting a blistering 56% from the field and are up by 12 points on the Heat. So High Tech absolutely dominating the Heat in the paint. with 18 points in the paint versus Saigon Heat's 8 points in the paint. And the local players for High Tech really stepping up this game. All five starters on the scoreboard, especially Dawson and Montien with 9 and 7 points respectively. Really had a great first quarter. Lazy pass from Munn, and he's going to tie up Chris Charles to prevent the easy dunk. So smart foul by Munn, but a poor pass. Heat were actually up 7-6 in that first period before High Tech went on a 21-8 run to close out the period. But Fanchun Munn gets called for the technical. They're saying that Charles had the breakaway. A point there. I don't quite agree, but I'm not the referee. So Fanchun Munn, local player, interesting story. Fanchun Munn, the star sub for the Heat, is actually a military officer. He's in the Vietnamese Army, and Vietnam gave him permission to actually represent his country for the Saigon Heat. So Munn getting a rare exception to play basketball and represent Vietnam. Coach Carboletto and team owner and Connor Nguyen are both very proud of the effort that Munn has given this season despite his limited minutes. Always hustling and always giving 110% on the floor. You can always count on that from Fanchun Munn. Meanwhile, Tien trying to guard Stephen Thomas. Thomas misses, but Charles is there for the follow. So Trent Dien Thun is the sole big man, local big man for the Saigon Heat. Had a lot of back problems to start the season, but has been able to strengthen his conditioning and is now matched up against Stephen Thomas, who probably outweighs him by a third. Wow, great ball movement from High Tech. Williams collects the rebound. It's a one-on-one fast break. Williams, Euro step. Williams showing he has a handle as well. Thomas finds Montien open in the corner, and he drains another three. Wow, Montien. Goodness gracious. It's 10 points for him, and he has started this game absolutely on fire. Baguian, one of the best pick and roll players in the league, finds Dien Thun, fouls. So Dien Thun gets his head to the free throw line. Montien finally gets a blow. What a start from Wang Sawengthem Montien. Watana Sudasin, or Kanu, checks in for Montien. And Sukhdave Gogar will also get his first action for High Tech. So Trent Dien Thun has played 7 games for the Saigon Heat this year, 7 out of 19 games. Misses the free throw badly. The thing about the Saigon Heat crowd is they're always pulling for their local players. So they want to see him make this one. So then we get a second chance. In and out. Nice recovery there by Thun. But Kanu is going to try his luck. No luck that time. Charles gets another offensive rebound. Gogar, again, so you can see that without another big international import, it's tough to box out High Tech Bangkok City. Baguian trying to work it into Thun, who has the size advantage, but Williams is going to take it all the way. No, Avenido for three. Short. Gets his rebound. Avenido. Wow, up and under move. Clever stuff from Avenido, who's having a great season, averaging nearly 15 points a game. Avenido has those crafty, wily old man moves in the post. speaking of old man moves, Kabahub loves that fadeaway. Baggyan, oh, no look pass is blocked. Wow, so three-man substitution for the Heat. Out come Mun, the Magician, and Avenido. In come Arnold, B-Win, number four, and Dmitry Guchko. Also lay in for Mun. So a whole new look. We've never seen this lineup for the Saigon Heat. Coach Carvalho trying to get his other players some burn, an opportunity to shine here. Arnold, pull up. He's usually money on those. He win. Praised by the team for being one of the hardest workers. Man. Charles misses badly on the follow-up. Here comes B. B to Lay. Lay into Williams. What a matchup. Williams and Charles. It's too strong. Charles gets another rebound. He might have 20 at the pace he's going. Pinata finds Canoe, drills it. It's almost like he was dancing when he caught that pass. I thought it might have been steps, but Canoe, a strong veteran player for High Tech. In fact, Sudison had 26 points in the last game for High Tech, which they lost to the Dragons. So he had a fantastic game, maybe still feeling it. So he drills the three. So Saigon Heat down by 20. Crowd is unusually quiet. Oh, cool. Canoe is gonna take it all the way. Does not finish. Gogar with the follow-up, good. So Sudave Gogar hustling down the court, establishing great offensive positioning and getting two follow-up layups. So strong play from Gogar. And that's the commentator's curse, right as I say that. He fouls B win. Then we'll check in for Williams. So with the exception of Guchko, we have an all-local team on the court. Oh, it's gonna be out of bounds, so Stephen Thomas, one of my favorite players in the ABL. He never stops hustling, even in the second to last game of the season. Stephen Thomas is hustling for the loose ball and throwing it off opposing players. You just love to have a guy like that on your team who's going to give it his all every play. Misconnection there from High Tech. Let's see if the Heat can get something going, get some rhythm. They've only managed to score 4 points this period. And B takes the pick. Thinks about it, gets it to Guchko. Step back, three. Good. That's Dimitri's third three-pointer, and he's showing he has the range to really stretch out defenses. The question is, on the defensive end, can he be strong enough to box out players like Stephen Thomas, Justin Knox, and Mo Tatua on the inside? What a fadeaway from Kabaha. He loves operating on the baseline. And when he's shooting that fadeaway jumper, it's basically impossible to block unless you're taller than him. So love to see that clever footwork from Kabaha. High Tech up by 21. Wow, and it's an absolutely packed arena here at CIS. You look at behind each hoop, there's not even space for one seat. So a lot of fans in today's game. cheering on their squad. Look at that. It's a packed crowd. You know, basketball, a relatively young sport for the country of Vietnam. Traditionally, Vietnamese love football. And the Saigon Heat have done so much to advance basketball in this country. This is their third season in the ABL. And they finally made the playoffs. So the home game for the Saigon Heat in the playoffs, which will likely be against the Malaysia Dragons, will be the 2nd of November at CIS Arena at 4 p.m. Ho Chi Minh time. That's the 2nd of November at 4 p.m. So those of you who are living in Vietnam, make sure to get your tickets now. I guarantee you, if this game is sold out, that first ever playoff game for the Saigon Heat will sell out very quickly. You can get tickets at www.ticketbox.com.vn. That's ticketbox.com.vn. Go get those tickets right away before they're sold out. And for those of you who can't come to the game, catch it on the live stream, 4 p.m. November 2nd. Wow, Lao Cool works the baseline. So in for High Tech, we have Sudasin, Gogar, Lao Cool, Kabahug, and Thomas. A strong take from Gogar, and he's fouled by Dimitri. Williams and Avenido check back for Lay and Guchko, actually. Excuse me, for Dunn. So, as the season's winding down, who are your picks for MVP for the All-ABL team? There's been so many standout players this season. And I think for me, you could make the case for players like Justin Knox of the Malaysia Dragons, Justin Williams from the Saigon Heat, certainly Chris Charles and Stephen Thomas, and even Avery Scherer for the Dragons, who's just made some incredible this season, incredibly clutch. But I think that in terms of overall importance to their team, it's hard to take away anything from Justin Williams. I mean, he's been an absolute rock for the Saigon Heat, leading the league in rebounds with nearly 18 rebounds a game, leading the league in blocks with nearly 5 blocks a game. And as any basketball coach will tell you, defense and rebounds are what they preach. And that's what Justin Williams has done this season. But there's been so many other great players this year in the ABL. So we see B win a little out of control, and it's going to be High Tech ball. So B win with his first turnover. He needs to slow down the pace a little bit. Baha, another fadeaway. Nothing but the bottom. And I can guarantee you that Patrick Kabahog has studied Kobe Bryant's move without fail. Fake left, fake right, go left. Kabahog, nothing but the bottom. It's beautiful stuff from the small forward. Avenido gets his first three, leading the league in 3-point field goals made, Leo Avenido. Avenido now has made 45 three-pointers in this fifth season of the AirAsia. That's by far first in the league. So that means he's making, let's do some quick math here, about 2.2 three-pointers a game. Amazing. So Saigon Heat with the top two bombers, with Viet Arnold and Leo Avenido. Oh, win. Gets sent packing, but the Heat crowd are liking his aggressiveness. as B goes to the free throw line. Winnoktan, or B, as his teammates call him. Hard worker. Point guard, plays some pesky D. But for B Win, what he really needs to work on is his shot. So I can guarantee you that B Win's gonna be approaching this offseason and really working on his outside shooting. Proves to be more than adequate from the free throw line. Nails both. So Heat here on a 5-0 run. Good defense. Arnold on Canoe. Oh, nice crossover. Canoe. B Win. Strong move. Great change of pace dribble from B Win. And maybe that's what he needs. So he takes that long step to get enough space to get some confidence. B Win matching up on Lur Lau Kul, who is a very quick point guard. Kabahug, no hesitation, off the mark. Williams with the rebound, he pushes it up the floor. Gets it back to B, B to Williams. Dimitri's open for three, good! And Guchko has made 4 3-pointers. What a start from Guchko. He's on fire, the Ukrainian bomber. It's nothing but twine. Making his case to be on the team for the playoffs. What a start for him. And he's got this crowd in a frenzy. Guchko is 4 for 6 with 12 points and 6 rebounds. That's a Heat fan showing off their moves. Crowd having some fun at CIS Arena, which is located in the outskirts of Ho Chi Minh, District 7. The Heat have gone on a mini run here, down by only 14 points. What a start from the Ukrainian three-point bomber, Dmitry Guchko. 4 for 4 from downtown. Goodness gracious. So the Dragons are up 63-27 over Drea. So it looks like Malaysia Dragons, another alley-oop pass, the second of the game. And Kenyatta to Charles, double C, connecting, triple C. Kenyatta to Charles connecting, goodness gracious. And they should patent that stuff. Guchko. Oh, nice defense there from Kabaho. Goes back to Bwin. Avenido steps back at three. You cannot give Avenido any space when he's behind that three-point line. He is gonna make you pay. Avenido with his 46th three-pointer of the season. Thomas absolutely bulldozes Guchko, and Guchko draws the offensive foul. What I love about Guchko is that he wears his emotions on his sleeve. As we watch the replay, he establishes position, and I didn't see much contact there. I think Guchko was a little, took some acting classes at home in Ukraine, but he acted well enough that he was able to draw the foul. And that's all that matters in this game. Heat on a run, narrow the deficit to 13. B Win fakes right, goes left. Wild pass is intercepted. almost a turnover from High Tech. So High Tech, well on their way to 100 points this game. Kenyatta blows by a win, rejected by the human eraser. 9 seconds left. Williams gets away with the chat. Oh, he didn't get away with it. The refs called him for it. So I think Williams could have given that one up. But after that stupendous block on the other end, the human eraser, Justin Williams. High Tech, 3 seconds left. Cabahug nails it. And that's going to count. So there was a whistle somewhere in the crowd. Play stopped. Refs talking it over. Basically what happened was there was a whistle from the crowd and the Heat player stopped playing, but time had not expired. So in my opinion, that three-pointer from Kabaha should count and give High Tech Bangkok City a 16-point lead. But officials will talk it over. Still discussing the call with the commissioner, as you can see. And that counts. So what a finish. Another buzzer beater against the Saigon Heat. And as we see assistant coach Kareem Hodge in his first game, discussing it over with the ref. But the Saigon Heat had been burned by so many buzzer beaters this season. In fact, when they were playing Indonesia Warriors in that critical game on Wednesday, Bonanza Sirigar just nailed a three-pointer to send it to overtime. It was, what an incredible shot from him. But that's the, I'd have to say, at least 10 buzzer beaters for opposing teams against the Saigon Heat. It's halftime. We're going to take about a 15-minute break, but you can follow along on the live stream. This is the Saigon Heat Hot Girls giving you a little performance, shaking their stuff, and keeping the crowd and you live stream viewers entertained. Two games going on right now. This game, as well as the Dragons versus Lascar Drea game, which you can also catch on the live stream. Take a break, watch the dancing and our other halftime performance coming up. Oh no! I hope she's okay. And the Saigon Heat Hot Girl, she's all right. She's all right, it was just part of the act. So it's okay. So tough spill for the Saigon Heat Hot Girls, but they're gonna come right back. She's all right, and we'll be back on the live stream in just a minute. That's DJ Rapsol in the house. Stay tuned, because we're going to have some sideline interviews. Team owner Connor Wynn will soon be interviewed on live stream, so stay tuned for that. As Rapsol keeps it pumping at CIS. That's definitely my favorite dancer right there. Goodness gracious. Thank you.
everyone who's wearing the red t-shirt or the red shirt, you can get the wristband from our team. And if your team wins there also, you also can get free motion from Subway. Keep our stuff and engage when we get Swedish. Thank you.
Và một thông tin nữa cho tất cả mọi người là vào ngày chủ nhật 30 tháng 11 sắp tới là chúng tôi có một cuộc chạy bộ với tên gọi là Cherry Fox Run để gây quỹ từ thiện nghiên cứu và
so after first half action, those of you who are on the live stream, just to catch you up. High Tech City up 51 to 35, absolutely dominated the Saigon Heat in the paint, 26 to 14 in terms of points in the paint. And High Tech showing off their depth with eight players scoring, led by Montian Wangsawangtum and Lutipong Dawson. Thai local players putting on a show here at CIS Arena. But speaking of shows, what can you say about Dmitry Guchko in his first game in the ABL, stepping in to the spot left vacant by Dustin Scott? Had a tremendous first half. The Ukrainian bomber, 12 points, 6 rebounds, 4 for 4 from beyond, from long distance. What a start for Guchko. But it's been all High Tech through two quarters. Just again, another reminder that the AirAsia ABL playoffs for the fifth season will be starting this Wednesday.
Thưa quý vị, ngay bây giờ xin mời quý vị hãy cùng gặp gỡ ông Connor Nguyễn, đồng chủ tịch câu lạc bộ bóng rổ Sài Gòn Heat. Xin chào ông, xin ông hãy cho biết ông đánh giá như thế nào về sự thể hiện của các cầu thủ Sài Gòn Heat từ đầu mùa giải đến giờ, nhất là các cầu thủ nội, họ có đáp ứng được nguyện vọng của ông cũng như ban huấn luyện hay không?
Good evening, sir. What do you think about your team performance this year, especially the local players? Did they play up to your expectation or not?
Well, one of our major goals was to make the playoffs, and we were able to do that. But I'm rarely satisfied, and certainly wanted our local players to even play a bigger role. They're improving very quickly, but I would always prefer for it to be quicker than that.
Thực sự mà nói thì mục tiêu của chúng tôi là được vào vòng bán kết và chúng tôi đạt được điều đó thì tôi rất là vui mừng. Thì đương nhiên tôi đã mong muốn là các cầu thủ nội có thể là chơi tốt hơn và có thể là thích nghi nhanh hơn với đấu trường quốc tế. Họ đã và đang là chơi rất là tốt, nhưng mà tôi còn mong kỳ vọng nhiều hơn thế nữa.
Thưa ông, trong phần trả lời phỏng vấn ở trận đấu trước, ông có khẳng định là đội bóng Sài Gòn Heat sẽ tiếp tục tham gia vào đấu trường ABL. Vậy đội bóng sẽ cần làm những gì và liệu các cầu thủ nội có cần thay đổi hay không và mục tiêu đề ra có cao hơn năm nay hay không?
In the last interview, you mentioned that Sài Gòn Heat will join the ABL next year. So how is the team preparing for the new season? And will you change the local player and what is the goal for the team next season?
So we have really big plans. In the off season, I think we're going to work much more closely with the Basketball Federation, combine teams and develop the players together. I'm very excited about that, and then we're going to start our very own professional basketball league in Vietnam for the first time. So very excited about that too.
Chúng tôi có một kế hoạch rất là lớn lao, và trong khi mà chúng ta không có mùa giải ABL nữa thì cho năm nay nữa thì chúng tôi sẽ bắt đầu làm việc với Liên đoàn bóng rổ Thành phố Hồ Chí Minh. Sẽ gộp hai đội lại với nhau và cùng huấn luyện với nhau, và tôi rất là vui mừng về cái kế hoạch đó. Đồng thời chúng tôi còn có ý định là sẽ tổ chức một giải bóng rổ chuyên nghiệp trong nước, và đó sẽ là một cái kế hoạch hứa hẹn rất là nhiều tiềm năng cho bóng rổ của Việt Nam.
Thank you so much. Cảm ơn ông rất nhiều.
Cảm ơn.
All right, so there you heard it. That's Connor Nguyen, one of the owners of the Saigon Heat franchise, saying that proud of his team for making the playoffs for the first time, but also talking about how his company XLE plans to really expand basketball and start a professional basketball league in Vietnam. It's really exciting news there from Connor. Stephen Thomas absolutely bullies Guchko on the block. And to start this third period, we have the magician with the ball, Froy Baggion, Guchko, Williams, Avenido, and Viet Arnold. So perhaps Coach Tony Carbaletto trying to experiment with a potential playoff starting five. Again, those of you just catching us now, Dustin Scott will no longer play for the Saigon Heat this season. The team had to release him because he had passport problems before the Indonesia Warriors game. The Saigon Heat still looking for a replacement. Oh, big man, a big man. I love seeing that. Thomas to Charles for the throwdown. So High Tech starts out with a 4-0 run. Avenida, wild pass, turnover. So with 4 minutes left in the fourth period, the Westport KL Dragons are up 96-52 against Laskar Drea South Sumatra. So they're guaranteed the number one spot in the AirAsia ABL playoffs. Kenyatta, that's too much space, and he drills the three, which means that the playoffs will be Dragons versus Heat and High Tech versus the Singapore Slingers. You can catch those playoffs this Wednesday on the live stream. Oh, Dawson a little out of control. The intensity has definitely picked up in this third period. Arnold, strong move, fouled. And that's one thing that Viet Arnold has shown this entire fifth season in the ABL, that he has an array of offensive moves. Viet Arnold, of course, whose mother is Vietnamese, his father is American. He played his college ball at Montana State Billings. And this is his first season as a pro. And what a first season it has been, as he has averaged 14.3 points per game, nearly 4 rebounds and 3 assists. But here's the thing. Viet Arnold is the second leading three-point shooter in the AirAsia ABL. He's made 44 threes this season. Excuse me. He's made 34 threes this season, but he shot 42% from downtown. And as you saw there, he can take it strong to the hole. So he's got those wide shoulders and some good hang time, body control. He's not afraid to take it to the big guys. So what a first season as a professional for Viet Arnold. There's a lot of Saigon Heat pride. Scores the first points for the Heat in this period. What a turnaround jumper from Charles. He's basically unguardable if he can make those shots from around the free throw line. Chris Charles. Arnold, pull up. Just short. Williams and Thomas battle for the rebound. Kenyatta. Oh. Speed Demon, another alley-oop to Charles. Throw down. And that is, I think that's the third time we've seen that. That's nearly three alley-oops this game, Kenyatta to Charles. Heat have to look out for that play. Bags, step back. Kenyatta, wraparound bounce pass. Oh, Montien went for the alley-oop. Misses the layup, Charles again. And High Tech is absolutely abusing the Saigon Heat. High Tech with 13 points already this period. So Guchko, even though he's had a great offensive showing, will have to really step it up in terms of boxing out other players. Speaking of hot offense, Leo Avenida, goodness gracious, 3 3-pointers already. And Kenyatta goes right around Baggion, and his ball trickles in. Kenyatta, so much speed off the dribble. Benito, air ball that time. So, tough start this period for the Heat. High Tech on a 15-4 run. Dawson blows right past Avenido, another layup. He recovers the ball, pushes it to Arnold. Arnold, rejected by Charles. But another strong take from Arnold, and there's going to be a foul against High Tech. That is Dawson's first foul. Arnold only has 1 point this game. Offense average of about 14 points a game. But the starting five for the Saigon Heat have played so many minutes this season, they deserve a break in this last game. All starters averaging about 35 or more minutes a game. So it's been a long and, of course, emotional year for the Saigon Heat. Meanwhile, Chris Charles with some fast footwork for a big man. Really fun to watch. Chris Charles, of course, good friends with Randy Foy, star NBA player. They had some workouts in the offseason. And it's really showed for him. Of course, last year, Chris Charles was the MVP of the league. Arnold intercepts the pass. Avenido on the break. I don't know what happened there. But it will be High Tech ball. So costly turnover for Avenido. They had a four-on-one break. Not sure what happened there. Montien finally misses a three, but that was in and out. That's as close as you're going to get. Montien gets a steal, and High Tech will set it up. Pierpont Piyun with the ball. Last time had a great crossover dribble. Last time he was here at CIS. Takes the three, nails it. So High Tech, as they start to pull away, you know, their shooters get more and more confidence. And Piyun with a great shot there. B10 trying to work the pick and roll. Goes around. Thomas. Williams can't finish. Neither can Guchko. Williams will get a third chance. No, Guchko. No. He gets the rebound. So that's four offensive rebounds for the Heat. Tan needs to give it up. Out of control. Throws it away. Kenyatta. Pipun, and that's how you run a fast break. Just perfect execution with the passing. Let's go. So, Williams exhorting B to get his head in the game. Avenido, nice pass to Guchko, takes it all the way. Nice finish. So, again, assist to field goal ratio. You see this beautiful bounce pass, Avenido to Guchko finishes. That's what the Saigon Heat need to do. Keep moving the ball and avoid the one-on-one play if possible. Speaking of passing, it's another great sequence there from High Tech. But Charles was off the mark. Williams, one-on-one stuff rejected by Charles. It's amazing how much distance a big man can take. You know, it looked like Williams took two steps and he went from the three-point arc to almost shooting a layup. I don't know how they do it. Amazing stuff. Munn with the ball. Munn gets it into Williams, throwdown. Williams had a dunk party last game against the Slingers 2 games ago. When he's that close, might as well put up the white towel. Forget it. He's going to throw it down on your head. Heat down by 26. 4 minutes to go in the third period.
Okay, so you ready? One, two, three, go! Yeah.
Dragons have just defeated Lascar Treya 100-56 in annihilation. Treya walks away limping after their first season in the ABL, only managing to win one game, but they'll be back. Their players work hard, and they were getting better as the season progressed. So hopefully we'll see Lascar Treya back in the ABL next season. This means the Dragons lock in that number one finish in this fifth season. And the Dragons have beat the Saigon Heat all four of their meetings. So they'll be heavy favorites in the first round of the ABL playoffs starting on Wednesday night. Catch it on the live stream. Wow, great hustle from Arnold. Trying to get the ball, does, gets it to Lay. Oh no, Diapong slips Thomas. Back to Kenyatta for the open three. No, Charles is down. Oh, what a putback. He extended his arms and it was like Jack and the Beanstalk. He just kept going. Just threw that down. Gosh, Chris Charles, so long. What a play. Williams is going to try his luck. Makes a mistake. Williams take that three-pointer all day. Williams makes that nice shot. Diapong pass. Rejected by Williams. That's the biggest block of the season. Charles gets it back, and Charles keeps hustling. And two of the best big men in the ABL going head-to-head, neck-to-neck, battling. But that was one of the best blocks I have seen in this fifth season. Goodness gracious, let's get a replay on that block. But the thing about Chris Charles is he didn't hang his head. He stayed in the play and he got another offensive rebound. Season for Chris Charles. Averaging 21 points, 14 rebounds, and 4 block shots per game. Williams is doing some more one-on-one stuff against Thomas. Passes to Lay. Lay, baseline, gets it to Munn, who's open for the three. Ooh, way off the mark. Hit the top of the backboard. Here's Luckhan. Passes too far for Diapong, but Kenyatta buries the three. And let me tell you something. When Jared Kenyatta is nailing three-pointers like that, high tech is really tough to beat. Lay, pull-up jumper, too strong. Williams, rebound, fouled. And Justin Williams has picked up the intensity for sure. He's got too much pride to let his Saigon Heat go down silently. Williams now with 14 points and 10 rebounds and 2 block shots. Meanwhile, his counterpart, Chris Charles, with 23 points, 12 rebounds, and 3 block shots. So Chris Charles winning that head-to-head battle so far. You can see the frustration from Justin Williams, shooting 42% from the stripe. I'm sure he's sad as the rest of Saigon Heat Nation is that Dustin Scott is no longer with them. What a block! Goodness gracious, I think Williams was about 2 feet above the rim there. Almost a goaltend. And he gets called for the foul against Gogar. And we see that Saigon Heat last couple possessions have been slow to get back on the transition deep. As we take a look at Sukhdave Gogar, has played 17 games for High Tech Bangkok City. Williams gets an ovation stepping out. Here's a little trivia. for you high-tech Bangkok City fans watching on the live stream, which five players from your team have played all 18 games for high-tech? You need some more time? Those five players have been Chris Charles, Stephen Thomas, Wootipong Dawson, Jared Kenyatta, and Bandit Lakon, who is on the floor at the moment. So they have played all 18 games this season for high tech. Munn goes left, pull up. Nice touch from Munn. That's great that Munn's looking for a shot. He going to a 2-3 zone, and they're playing with a lot more intensity in this second half. Arnold rips down the rebound. Arnold, Eurostep rejected from behind from Chris Charles. What recovery! Oh my god. Lakon goes right around Munn, takes it straight to the hole. No. And Hien Thun can't hold on. So, I mean, the timing that Chris Charles had on that block was just fantastic. I mean, it's so hard to time that when you're behind the play to make that sort of defensive effort as Kabaha continues his three-point cabal. I mean, this guy has played four games now for High Tech, the Filipino, and he is just deadly from beyond the arc. He scored 29 points in the last game against the Malaysian Dragons. Kabaha is definitely a top two offensive threat for High Tech. Lakon, nice pass to Gogar. Beautiful stuff. Split the defense. And as a basketball fan, there's nothing I love more than a good pass. So, great court vision there from Bandit Lakon. Arnold gets some help from the crowd about the shot clock. And Saigon Heat fall to 31 down after that third period. So despite the increase in intensity, it's been all high tech Bangkok City. We'll be right back.
Sớm giành quyền lọt vào vòng playoff mùa giải năm nay. Vậy những trận đấu còn lại có ý nghĩa như thế nào đối với đội bóng của ông khi hai Tech Bangkok City không cần phải cố gắng để giành quyền đi tiếp?
Sir, your team is already in the playoff, so of course they don't have a lot of pressure in the last few games anymore. So how do you expect your team to play in these games?
Well, first of all, every game we deal all our games with. Again, we don't like treat it like because we are in the playoffs, then we'll just give this game. No, we make sure that our players are all in task and is still like ready to fight and play the same intensity of game that we display in every game we have.
Chúng tôi tôn trọng tất cả các trận đấu mà chúng tôi chơi. Thì mặc dù chúng tôi đã vào được vòng bán kết, nhưng chúng tôi vẫn sẽ thi đấu với tinh thần là quyết liệt như khi chúng tôi chưa vào được vòng bán kết, và chúng tôi sẽ thi đấu hết mình và sẽ luôn luôn là tôn trọng khán giả để chơi hết mình.
Thưa ông, trong số những đội lọt vào vòng playoff gồm có Westport Malaysia Dragon, Singapore Stinger, Saigon Heat và High Tech Bangkok City, ông đánh giá đội bóng nào có lối chơi khó chịu nhất và sẽ là vật cản lớn nhất cho con đường đi đến thành công của đội ông?
Among the four teams that are in the playoff, Westport Malaysia Dragons, Saigon Heat, Singapore Slingers, and your team, which team is the most like challenging team for your team?
Well, this ABL season, all these four final teams are all like good teams, so it's always a challenge, and to be number one, it's just a matter of us for to demonstrate and give all our talents as coaching staffs so our players can contribute and display it to the final of this championship.
Thật sự mà nói cả bốn đội nào cũng đều rất là tốt và mọi người đều chơi rất là quyết liệt. Thì để có thể trở thành đội vô địch năm nay thì chúng tôi sẽ phải cố gắng hết sức để chiến thắng cả bốn đội, và cả bốn đội đều là những cái khó khăn đối với đội chúng tôi.
Thank you so much. Cảm ơn ông rất nhiều.
So the coach from High Tech saying all four teams in the playoffs are tough, and saying that High Tech needs to do whatever they can to be number one. Well, it's too late for that, as the Dragons have beaten Las Cardrea and will be the number one team this year. So High Tech will be number two. But I agree with him that Justin Williams, a step back from 20, that all four teams have a shot. I think the Dragons will be heavy favorites against the Heat, and High Tech will be favorites against the Slingers. But in the best of three format, anything can happen. And these teams are all close enough where they can score some upsets. So again, remember, you can catch the ABL playoffs October 29th. That's Wednesday night on the live stream. All four teams will be playing then. Excuse me. So in to start this fourth period, a lot of local players: Phan Chuan Mun, Ryan Lay, B Win, and Tran Tien Tan. Justin Williams, the big man, anchoring the defense. Williams with the rebound. Two players on him right now. Nice pass to Tan Tan. No foul called. Mun dish to Williams. Off balance layup. Nice pass there for Mun. And local players really want to show something here in this last period for the Heat. Charles, jump hook. Good. Just solid fundamentals for the big man. A lot of fun to see. B-Win trying to use the pick and roll. Goes around Gogar. B-Win lay to Mun. He's open in the corner for three. Short. So Mun has had a few good looks for three-point shots, but unable to convert. Meanwhile, Bandit Lacan, he's off the mark. But another nice tip in from Chris Charles. And he is having a fantastic game. Man. Chris Charles now with 25 points and 13 boards. Six of them offensive. Williams way off the mark on that jumper. One amazing stat about Chris Charles is that Chris Charles this season, both him and Stephen Thomas have 99 offensive rebounds, which is tied for second in the league. Justin Williams has 112 offensive rebounds out of 225 rebounds total. Meaning Williams is getting half of his rebounds on the offensive end. Oh, another huge block from Chris Charles. Sends Williams packing. Guchko gets to the Williams, who was hacked by Gogar. But we are seeing the battle of the big men. Mutombo 1 against Mutombo 2. Williams and Charles, this is fun to watch. It's like watching, so we see the foul on Gogar here. It's like Wilt and Russell going at it in for Southeast Asia. We've seen some monster blocks on both ends. Williams makes the free throw. in and out. So far, High Tech is just dominating points in the paint. 42 of their 89 points have been in the paint, and whereas the Saigon Heat only have 22 points in the paint. Fahan loses it. Some careless ball handling there. B win. Dish to Williams. Great play from B win. If you watch it, he made sure Charles committed to him first before dropping off the pass. That's how you run a fast break. Well, this is fun to watch. Charles going up against Williams. Play hand. Another three. Quick release. No. Guchko rebound. B's got it in the open court. What's he going to do? Gets it to Guchko for three. Good! Five three-pointers. He's getting the crowd into it. The Ukrainian bomber just gets it over Chris Charles. Govar comes right back on defense. So again, B-Win getting some extended burn here. Draws the foul on Bandit Clahan. Guchko, 5 for 5 from downtown, 19 points. The man with the red stripe on his back and no number is killing it from the outside. Lay takes the pick and roll for Williams. He goes all the way, finger roll, leaves it short. Lay has got to finish that layup. It's a good strong take. I'm sure he would love to have that one back. Meanwhile, Hong Yalan has checked in for the Heat. Hong Yalan, number 8. Coaches say he has the best skills for local players on the Saigon Heat team. But just a little undersized, so hasn't gotten many minutes. So let's see what he can do now in the last 5 minutes of this game. B-Win gets a set of double screens. Nice pass to Williams. No! It's a great look from B-Win, though. Lernauku to Canoe. And that splash. That's too easy for Canoe. That Canoe made no splash. That was all net for the three-point marksman from High Tech. Lay wants a three, way off the mark there. So with Baggion, Viet Arnold, and Avenido on the bench, the Saigon Heat reserves have struggled to score. High Tech Bangkok City are in double figures, really showing their balance. Chris Charles with a monster 27 points and 15 rebounds. Meanwhile, Montien, Jared Kenyatta, Canoe, and Gogar with a solid game, 10 points, all in double digits. And despite this being a somewhat meaningless game in terms of playoff positioning for both teams, when you are competing and you have players like Justin Williams and Chris Charles going at it, you know, the competitive juices start flying and it's like they're not going to give any ground, and there's been some amazing blocks this game. Chris Charles would have gotten another block there if it wasn't a foul. Mun, the military man, hits the free throw. He's got 3 points now, Mun does. Mun's gonna dive for the ball. Slides. That's what you love about Mun. He gives 110%. Such a physical player. And the Heat are gonna really need his energy off the bench, and more importantly, a focused, smart energy where he's taking the right shots and making the right plays. But you can never fault a player for giving 110%. Heat in the 2-3 zone, as we have Lerlaukul. Look at how the high tech is just moving it around. Finds Gogar, no. Tip in by Charles, just off the mark. Charles just has that uncanny instinct for the ball around the hoop. Such great timing. Lerlaukul putting some pressure on Bwin. He gets it to Mun. Mun, pick and roll with Williams. He's gonna take it all the way. Wild pass. Kuchko to Williams. Throws it down. That's just pure power there. I mean, watch Williams with the hop step, and then you know he's gonna get up there. Another dunk for Williams. Dunk party continues for him. He wins. Where is he gonna go? Nice dish to Gushko. Finish. Great vision from B. Win. What a dish. That's what I love to see, and I'm sure Coach Carbaletto and all of his teammates love to see it too. B has played about 15 minutes this game, and he has 3 assists to go along with 4 points. B does have 3 turnovers as well, so he does have to polish up some of his decision making, but he's showing that he has some real potential to be a great point guard. Watching us now, one more reminder to those of you Saigon Heat fans, the most loyal fans. Someone has just collapsed on the floor. Let's hope it's nothing serious, but someone on the Saigon Heat, the trainer for the Saigon Heat, has just collapsed on the floor. And let's hope he's okay. I think it looked like he fainted. And this crowd, which has been through so much with, of course, the passing of Coach Jason Rabideau, is just absolutely on edge. We're all just praying right now that the trainer for the Saigon Heat is okay. Just took a spill. We're just gonna make sure he's all right. It's just been a tough season for the Saigon Heat team and Saigon Heat fans. And you can see players on both sides just really hoping that the trainer is okay. We have medical staff checking his pulse, and we'll be letting you know. But all of you on Livestream Nation, I'm sure you're all praying for us, praying for Saigon Heat and our trainer, who gets up gingerly, and let's hope he's okay, but he's on 2 feet, and that is a big sigh of relief for the Saigon Heat team, a huge sigh of relief. The way he fell was a really bad fall. He just fainted, and just a quiet crowd here, hoping that our trainer is okay. So Coach Carboletto tries to regroup his players. And it's just a reminder that this is just a game. And to just respect every moment of this life, as I'm sure all of you and our Saigon Heat players do. Such a tragic season for them. But they're happy to be back in the playoffs, and we're happy that our trainer seems to be okay. So, resuming the action, Bangkok, High Tech Bangkok City, 94 points to the Saigon Heat's 67 points. Dawson, short on the jumper. Williams gets another rebound. That's his 16th rebound. Bwin finds Hong Yalan, who gets his first touch this game. Mun, one-on-one moves against Adaporn, former MVP. Nice rebound from Guchko. Goes up and under, no. Get a second chance, no good. So good effort from Dimitri. Doesn't get it that time. And the Heat players struggling to get back into this game after that collapse. Nice play from Dawson. Just gets it over Williams. And Dawson very comfortable around the basket. He's got just that soft touch. He can go high. He can go strong. And he's going to be a really key part for High Tech Bangkok City. Hong Yalan for his first three, no. Mun gets the offensive rebound. High Tech in the 2-3 zone. Bwin, stutter step all the way. Nice move in and out. A great move from Bwin. He's really got a handle as Lert Laukul hits the deck. So Coach Carboletto now giving the fans a treat with an all-local team. Four out of the five players are local. So we have Tony Nguyen, number one, guarding the ball right now. Phan Chan Mun, Tien Tan, and Hong Yalan. Tien Tan, nice rebound. And here comes Tony Nguyen, very skilled player. Nguyen finds Mun, he's open for three, he's gonna try again, he's way off the mark, somehow gets his own rebound. And no one boxed out Mun. Mun now, his stat sheet, only got 3 points, but he's got 3 steals, 2 assists, and 4 rebounds. So Mun just showing his effort this game. Yalan gets it into Tony. Tony to Mun, Heat trying to work it around. Mun back to Tony. Tony, pull up, jumper, what a shot from Tony Nguyen. Viet Arnold is on the sideline and he's loving it. Troy Baggion, Avenido, Viet Arnold loved that offensive move from Tony Nguyen. Tony Nguyen was actually on an ABL segment head to head and he's a really smart fella. He knew all sorts of stuff that I didn't even know. So, great stuff there from Tony Nguyen, who takes the pick and roll from Dimitri. Nice pass to Mun, intercepted from Dawson. So, as this quarter winds down, High Tech Bangkok City will move to a 14-5 record behind Westport Malaysia Dragons with a 15-5 record. Dimitri just misses the jumper. And if High Tech wins their last game against the Slingers, they'll share the same record with the Dragons, but because the Dragons have the head-to-head victory in terms of point differential, Dragons finish with number one seed. Bangkok City up 100-69. They crossed that magical 100 point mark. It's been a real team effort on offense for High Tech. Tan Tan, turnaround, just gets it over Bergar. And that's got to give Tan Tan a lot of confidence. And it's great to see the local players getting on the board. Speaking of local players, Dawson, Just Long, Adaporn, having some fun. They're Laokul. No. And Hong Yalan with the rebound. 15 seconds left. Yalan goes all the way. What a pass from Yalan! So Yalan, Tony Nguyen, and Chan Tien Tan with consecutive baskets. And Mun's going to go all the way. Nice finish from Mun. So Dawson didn't challenge the layup. And the Heat local players each score to finish the game. So a nice gesture from Wutipong Dawson and High Tech Bangkok City. We have a solid win, 100-75. We're gonna have some sideline interviews in just a moment with players and coaches, so stay with us. But it has been fun game, and both teams with nothing to lose, still played with a lot of pride. And High Tech Bangkok City had 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 players in double figures, led by Chris Charles with 27 points, 16 rebounds, 8 of them offensive, and 5 monster block shots from all angles. For the Saigon Heat, the bright spot, besides Justin Williams' consistent play, was what Dmitry Guchko from the Ukraine. What a game for Dmitry. 21 points, 15 rebounds, 5 for 5 from beyond the arc. And the local players, Fan Chan Mun, Tony Pham, B Win, and Tran Tien Tan finally getting their spotlight in front of this sold-out crowd at CIS Arena, putting up some points on the board and giving their crowd something to cheer about. So the Saigon Heat now drop to 9-11 in their third season in the ABL. So they didn't quite break the 500 mark, but they made the playoffs, and it's going to be an exciting game on Wednesday night between the Saigon Heat and the Westport Malaysia Dragons. Catch that one Wednesday on the live stream, and you local fans, be sure to buy your tickets for the Saigon Heat home game, which will be on November 2nd, that's Sunday, at 4 p.m. Buy tickets at ticketbox.com.vn. Go do it now if you're listening, because those tickets are going to sell out fast. Coach Tony Carbolato from the Saigon Heat is about to be interviewed. So just stay with us for another minute. This is your commentator, Darren Joe. It's been a joy commentating these games for you on the ABL live stream. And I'm proud of our Saigon Heat finally making the playoffs. I can tell you that all the players were absolutely overjoyed after we beat the Indonesia Warriors in overtime in a dramatic fashion. And I have to give a shout out to Mark Yi from the Philippines, who stepped in and played one game for us and played incredible basketball. And in a large part because of his help and toughness, the Saigon Heat are in the playoffs for the very first time. All right, it looks like we're not gonna have our sideline interview. So we'll see you on Wednesday on the live stream. Playoff action, Heat versus Dragons. Don't miss it. Wednesday night. See you soon.
What happened? Who was that guy?